Hey guys, I am super excited to show you how you can create an awesome looking animated neon lighting effect on the text that is super easy to create inside of DaVinci Resolve without using any third-party plugins. You can use this animation to create lyrical music video. This is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's take a new project and get started. Alright, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 17 edit page, and before we get started we have to do some basic setting as usual. So click on the setting button right over here in the corner and set the size of this project first. So in this case I am using this 1920 by 1080 HD resolution. You can select 4K resolution as well. So here we have the Ultra HD resolution. Now we have to select a frame rate. So in this case I am using this 30 frame per second, but if you want to select, then you can select 60 frame per second for a smooth animation or 24 frame per second for cinematic, but I am using 30 frame per second. And now you can click on save. Now we have to create this animation inside of this Fusion page. So what we have to do, it's very simple. Just go to this media pool. If you don't have this media pool, then click on this media pool button. You can right click on this media pool window and click on this new Fusion composition and take a new Fusion composition. First of all, we have to set the duration of this composition. So I'm going to use 3 seconds long, which is good enough for one slide. In this case, I'm going to call it Fusion composition. You can call it anything. It doesn't really matter. And select the frame rate 30 frame per second. Click on create. Now just drag this Fusion composition on the timeline just like that, and then you can go on this Fusion page, and here we have to do all the setting. So just close this spline window. Here we have the media out node. So just drag this media out to the side for now, and here we have two different window, but for this animation we need only one viewer. So you can close the second viewer and you can keep it the simple one viewer. And now let's start by creating a background. So for the background, I'm going to use an image. So just go to this media pool, right click on this media pool, click on import media. I'm going to use this image, and I think I have downloaded this from unsplash.com, and I will give you a link in the description so you can download this free image for practice. Click on open. Just drag this image on this flow window just like that, and you can close the media pool. And here we have the media pool. Hit F2 on the keyboard to rename. It's very simple. Let's rename it to image. Hit OK. And now you can drag this image to the viewer, and as you can see it's looking like this. But you can use any different image. Make sure your image should be similar like this on a black background. Alright, now we have to fit this image because this is 1920 by 2400, a different proportion, but we need 1920 by 1080 proportion. So how to fit this image? It's very simple. Let's take a new background node. So this is the background icon. Let's drag and drop a background node on this flow window. Hit F2, and I'm going to use this background as a matte. So let's call it matte. Now you can see it's looking like this. You can click on fit button. And after that, I'm going to fit this image inside of this black section. So it's very simple. Let's take a new merge node. You can also connect this matte with this image, but let me show you another way. Let's take a new merge node, and inside of this merge node we have 4 different points, as you all know. So this is the output. This is the green point for foreground, and this is the yellow point for background. So I'm going to use this matte as a background and this image as a foreground. So let's connect the yellow point with this matte and green foreground point with this image and drag and drop to the viewer. After that, you can change the operator over to in. And after that, we have to attach a controller. So select the image, add a transform node, and this transform is going to be the controller of this image. So hit F2 on the keyboard. You can also right click on this transform node and click on rename. I'm going to call it image controller. And now you can control the image from this transform. So select the controller, go to inspector window. If you don't have this inspector window, you can click on this button. You can increase the size of this image just like this. After that, We have to attach a color corrector node just after this merge. So select the merge. Here we have the color corrector option. Click on this button and we will get the color corrector node. Drag it to the viewer. Here we have to change some settings. So let's down the saturation value 0 and make it black and white. You can decrease the gain, and I'm going to set the opacity of this image maybe 10%. So we have to set the value 0.1. It's looking perfect. After that, we have to attach a text. So for the text, we have this icon T. Let's drag this text on this flow window. Let's take a new merge node. I'm going to use this output as a background and this one as a foreground. So let's connect the yellow point with this color corrector and green foreground point with the text. Let's drag this merge to the viewer. Select the text and let's type a text, whatever you want to type. So I'm going to type design. You can type anything. And now we have to select our font style. So in this case, I'm going to use a bold font style for this. So this is the Gobold font style. I will give you a link in the description. You can download this font. And now let's increase the size of this font. I'm going to set the value 0.35. You can set the size according to you. And after that, we have to align the text in the center. So it's very simple. Just go to preview window, right click on that, go to guide and turn on the guide. And we have to set the text just like this. Now it is on center. Click on fit button. After that, we have to down the opacity of this text. So select the text one, go to setting, and here we have the opacity. Let's down the opacity and set the opacity 10%. So I'm going to set the value 0.1. After that, we have to animate the text. For the animation, we need to add a transform node. So this is the transform button. Let's attach a transform node just after the text. So hold shift on the keyboard and you can attach the transform node just like this. All right. Now, right click on that, click on rename, call it animation 01. And now we have to animate the text. Just go to on frame number 30, which is equal to 1 second according to 30 frame per second. Select the animation 01, go to inspector window, and here we have the center. Right click on center, click on animate, go to on frame number 60, right click on center, click on set key, and lock the value as it is on frame number 60 and 30. And then go to the end of this animation. Let's drag the text outside of this frame, just like this. And here we have to set the Y value negative 0.5 and go to very first frame of this animation. This time we have to set the value 1.5 and we will get this type of animation. You can click on fit button, go to a spline window, check this option animation 01. You can minimize it, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen, click on fit button. Now select these two keyframes, hit S on the keyboard to smooth, or you can also click on this smooth button. Select these two keyframes, hit S to smooth. Set the CTI at very beginning of this animation, maybe on first keyframe. Hold this handle and just drag it like this and create a nice smooth curve. Hold this handle as well and let's set it like this. Go to the end of this animation, maybe on last keyframe, and let's set the handle just like this. Let's highlight this handle and set it like this. And now we have the smooth curve. You can close the spline window. Go to very first frame and let's have a look. And now it's looking perfect. After that, we have to add one more text. So let's attach one more text node over here. This is the second text, and for this text let's type same thing in lowercase, just like this. Now let's merge the text. So for the merge, you can also connect the foreground output with the background output and you will get a new merge 3 node. You can drag and drop to the viewer. Select the text, and for this one we have to select a cursive or any signature font style. You can select any font style that you like, but In this case, I'm using this Broetown signature. I will give you a link for this font so you can download this font from the link given in the description. You can increase the size and set the size maybe 0.4. All right, and it's looking like this. After that, we have to create a glow effect on the text. So what we have to do, just select the text, hit Control and space bar for search box and search for glow. So this is the glow node, hit add button. Set the glow size maybe 10, glow 0.8. Let's add one more glow effect. So select the glow, hit Control plus space bar again. Select the glow effect, hit add button. And for this one, we have to increase the glow size. So let's set the size 50. Let's add one more, select this one, hit Control plus space bar, hit add button. And this is the third glow. Let's increase the glow size and set the value 100. And now it's looking like this. All right, you can arrange these glow effects just like this. All right, and after that, we have to animate the text. So select the text 2 and go to on frame number 40. And let's animate the write on value. So right click on this write on, click on animate, and go to on frame number 10 right over here, and let's set the value 0, and we will get this type of animation. And I'm going to create a copy of this text. So select the text, hit Control C to copy, hit Control V to paste, hit F2, and you can call it stroke, hit OK. And now we have to remove this animation attached with this text. So go to the end of this animation, right click on write on, and let's click on this option remove all from write on group. And as you can see, we don't have any animation. After that, I'm going to use this text as an stroke for this. So what we have to do, let's take a new merge node, and I'm going to use this stroke as a background and this output as a foreground, just like this. All right, and now you can drag and drop this merge 4 on the viewer. We have to down the opacity of this. So select the stroke, go to setting, and let's down the opacity and set the value 0.25, maybe 25%. And after that, you can connect the output of this merge with this merge 3, just like this. Drag the final output. And after that, we have to animate this text as well, but in opposite direction. So what we have to do, we have to create a duplicate of this animation 1. So select the animation 1, hit Control C to copy, hit Control V to paste. And this is the second animation, so hit F2 on the keyboard, and you can call it animation 02. After that, we have to attach this animation just after this merge 4. So you can create space, hold shift on the keyboard, and attach this animation just like this. But as you can see, both the text in same direction, so we have to reverse this direction. So just select the animation 02, go to the end of this animation, and let's exchange the value. Here we have the y value negative 0.5, so we have to set the value 1.5, and go to very first frame of this animation. And here we have the value 1.5. So let's reverse this value and set the value negative 0.5. And now we will get this type of animation, which is looking nice. You can take a look. All right. And after that, we have to add one more animation. So select the animation 02, hit Control plus a space bar for search box and search for DVE. So this is the DVE effect, hit add button. And in this effect, we have the X, Y, and Z axis. So I'm gonna animate the Y axis. Just go to the end of this animation. Let's rotate it and set the value negative 30 degree. Right click on this Y, click on animate, and go to very first frame of this animation, and let's set the value 30 degree, and we will get this type of 3D looking animation. Select the DVE, go to spline window, hit F4 to full screen. Check this only DVE, click on fit button, select both the keyframes, click on a smooth button. And now we have this smooth animation, you can close the spline window. The animation is almost ready. Now we have to colorize this. So it's very simple. Just select the final output, add a color corrector node. And this color corrector node is going to be the color. So hit F2 to rename and let's call it color. Hit OK. Drag this color to the viewer. You can pick any color from here and you can down the saturation value and create a nice good looking color just like this. You can use any color that you like. I'm going to use this purple color maybe. All right, and now you can see the effect. And after that, we have to apply grain effect on the whole animation to avoid the color bending. So it's very important step. Just select the final color node, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for grain. So this is the grain, hit add button, hit Ctrl and scroll up to zoom in. Just drag this color one to the viewer and as you can see the effect, but this is too much. Let's down the value. So here we have the power. Let's set the value 2. And now it's looking perfect. You can click on fit button. And finally, we have to attach the main output with this media out and you can go on the edit page. And as you can see, we will get something like this. And now let me show you how you can create multiple slides. It's very simple. Select the fusion composition, hit Ctrl C to copy, place the CTI at the end of this. Hit Ctrl V to paste and this is the second copy. Place the CTI on the second composition, go to fusion page and here we have to change the text inside of this text 1, text 2 and the stroke. So select the text 1 and you can type anything that you want. You have to type the text in the text 1 in capital letter just like this. And for these two texts, we have to type in the lowercase. So select the text 2 and let's type same thing in lowercase. And after that, you can change the color. So here we have the color node. You can pick any color that you like. Just like this. And then you can go to the edit page and here we have the second slide. And as you can see, it's looking very nice. Let's take a look. So click on this look button, go to very first frame, go to full screen and let's have a look. All right, so it's looking awesome and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos. Also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikash and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.